All right, welcome to today's webinar. In the upper right-hand corner, go into Settings. On the left-hand side, go to Integrations. This will show you a Zapier API key. Every user has their own Zapier API key. Click on the little copy button, and it will copy that code to your clipboard. So now, what we're going to do is we're going to go over here to Zapier.com. Typically, the things that people want to use Zapier for is bringing in leads. I can click on Make a Zap. You've got two things. Over here on the side, you've got a trigger. A trigger is what causes this Zap to trigger. So you have to choose an application of some sort. In this case, I want to do Zillow. So I'm going to type in, just start typing in Zill, and it has found Zillow Tech Connect. I want to grab that one. Then it starts you through this menu of things that you can do. Zillow only has one trigger that it can do, and that trigger is whenever a new contact comes into their lead database. I click on Save and Continue because that's what I want to do. Whenever a new lead comes in, I want that to happen. So then it says, hey, go to your Zillow account, go into Account, connect to my CRM, and then add a partner. Select the Zapier menu choice and then click Save. Whenever it does that, it's going to ask you what is the email address. And for this account that I'm logged in as, it's the support@realvolve.com. You would use whatever account that you log into Zapier with. So in Zillow, if I sign in account, connect to my CRM, and then click on Add Partner. And it's going to ask what partner. You come down here to Zapier, okay? Here's where it's going to ask for that email address. You would put in your Zapier email login and then click Save. Now I come back. Since I've done that now, I can say, okay, I did this. So now it's going to go out there and just check to see, did you do it? In which case, it's looking for a contact, and boom, it says, hey, I tested successfully. Just click on Continue. Now we have to know the action. In our case, our action is going to be we want to bring that lead into RealVolve. Once it triggers, what's the action? Bring it into RealVolve. Again, we can come up here and start typing Real, and it'll show you all the different things. Choose RealVolve from the list. Create contact. So a contact's put into Zillow. We want it to go into RealVolve. We're going to choose the action of create contacts. I'm going to click on save and continue. Now it's going to ask which RealVolve account do I want to put this in. If I don't have anything in here, I can click on create an account, which I already have a training one here, but I'm going to show you how to do this. We'll click on create an account, and it pops up this window, and it's asking for that API key. Now we had gone into RealVolve originally into the settings area and copied the API key. So I should be able to come over here and paste, and there's that long API key from RealVolve. That makes the connection between RealVolve and Zapier and make sure that it's your account because every user has their own Zapier API key. I'm not going to because I already have it over here. I don't want to confuse things. But I would say yes and continue, and then it would create an item over here. In this case, I am using the training. Now I'm going to click on save and continue. We've got full name, title, company, home address, all this information that needs to be filled in. The way you fill that in is if you want to pull it from the data from Trigger, you click on the little menu button here, and it's going to show you all the fields that are available from that trigger. In this case, there is a first name and a last name. There's also one because Zillow has it. We could just use the full name. Okay, I'm going to, just for purposes of showing you a feature here, I'm going to choose the first name. That puts in a field right there. So that's where the first name is going to be. For RealVolve, we're looking for the full name. And the full name needs to be the name and then a space. So I'm going to put my space bar. And then I'm going to click on that menu again and choose the last name. So you can build sentence structures or word math is what I like to call it to say, okay, whatever the first name is, plus a space that's in between there, plus whatever's in the last name field, put that into this one field right here, full name. There is a home phone. There's also a home mobile number. Now, For RealVolve, we utilize the home mobile number thinking that it is the most unique number. One thing that we do is if there is a mobile number, we do a lookup in RealVolve before we add this contact to see if this contact is already in the database by looking at the mobile number and also the email address. If we get one or both of those, we do a lookup to see if that contact exists. So typically I say put in the information for the home mobile number for whatever phone number you got. So in this case, contact phone is going to go into the home mobile number. I don't know if it's mobile or not necessarily, but they might enter a form multiple times. I don't want them to go into my database multiple times. I want to do a lookup, see if they're in there already. Same type of thing for the home email. If I click on the little menu choice here, there is a email address. So I'm going to click on the home email and choose that. There's a place here for the tags. I might want to type in new lead. You can put a comma and then whatever else you want in there. Another thing that you can do is you can put in like comma and then come over here and choose one of the fields. Maybe I want to say property types, single family, you know, whatever. So I'm going to click on that as a possible tag so that I know what they're looking for. The contact source. So that contact source, normally, if you click on the down arrow on this, there are certain choices. You can only pick one of those choices. Unlike a tag, you can pick multiple tags. This one, you can only pick one. This list is created from your settings. So if I come over here into settings, and I look at contact source types, here's all the settings. If you want to create your own custom label, say, you know, www.myleadpages.com, you know, whatever you want to call that, click save, then that will add www.myleadpages.com down here. So I can create my own sources, but there's only one choice. Now, if I come back over here to my Zap and look in this contact sources, I click on the down arrow on this, it's going to hit RealVolve and it looks at what sources are in that list. And boom, there's www.myleadpages.com. Zillow is a normal list item, so you know you can set that up in RealVolve. By default, we don't put anything in there. We want you to set those up, so it's important that you put something in there. If you don't, then and you come here, there's nothing going to be in the list. So if you're missing things, you want to add them, go to your sources in RealVolve, add them, and then you can click on this, check RealVolve and reload, and it'll reload it. If it's already got a load, then it'll reload it again and put whatever's in there. So I know that this list is coming from Zillow. I'm going to go ahead and choose Zillow. Now, this lead comes in, and we've not filled out everything yet. I'm going to fill out some more. I want to be able to assign a workflow to it. Whenever you click on the down arrow here, it will go out to RealVolve and it'll find any contact workflows that are in your list. So if I come over here to RealVolve, I look at workflows, and if I do a filter just by contact workflows, it'll show me a list of all the workflows that are in my contact list that are just contact workflows, and I can pick and choose from them from this list. So I may have one here that says, a new lead with SMS notification to record owner. Okay, so this is just a simple one. I'm going to choose that just so that there's one in there. And then whenever this lead gets put into the database, it will run that workflow, start it, and everything's automatic from that point. The next field in here is the record owner. Now, because every Zapier API key is assigned to a RealVolve user, that API key, we know who the RealVolve user is, and it should be assigned automatically, but you can click on the down arrow here, and you can choose somebody else. If I wanted to, say, Mark is always going to mess with this, so I could assign the record owner to any leads just to Mark if I wanted. The other option I have, you go into the settings. There's this record owner assignments option. Okay, now what this is a way that they can assign record owner here in Zapier in a round robin type of format. So what you can do is click on the little, I've got some in here. I'm just gonna leave those, but I'm gonna click on a new one here. And I'm going to say my Zillow leads. And I wanna do it as a round robin list. So basically what's going to happen is Joe Agent will get one, and then Annie Assistant will get one. Once Annie's gotten hers, then it'll go back to Joe. So it'll be distributed equally. You may have, you know, a dozen names in here, and you can pick whichever ones you want. And we click on Save. So now, if I come back over here into RealVolve, go into the record owners, click on the down arrows, here's this MyZilla leads is a list. So if I choose that one, then first it'll go to Joe for the first lead. The second lead will go to Annie, and then it'll go back to Joe. So it gets an equal distribution of names in your system. So if you look up here, the question is if record owner is assigned to a certain person, can the workflow be assigned to whatever? So in this case, what I'm doing is I'm using a workflow that uses the record owner as the key. So if I come over here to workflows and go to new lead with SMS notification, it has four items that it does. And if you look over here, every one of them is assigned to whoever the record owner is. So if Joe gets this lead, these items will be assigned to Joe. Whenever Annie gets them, it'll be assigned to Annie. That's pretty much, you know, how the record owner stuff works. Notes, I can come in here and click on the little down arrow, and I can say, okay, there is a message field in Zillow. I want to put that in there. Now, there's a lot of fields in Zillow that we don't have in our contact, but say, for instance, you wanted to know more information, you want to bring that information into that contact record, into the notes field. It's going to put this message one in there. I can come in here and say, well, there's other fields that I want in that note as well. So I want, maybe I want the list price that of this property that they're working at. So I can choose that. But if I see that number there by itself in the note, I may not know what it is. So what I want to do is go right in front of that field and say list price, colon, and it'll put whatever that is in that field and go to the next line. So again, more word math, what I like to call word math. So whatever label you've got, the field, next line, you can do that. And there's like minimum price, I think it is, maximum price. There's several different ones for criteria. Here's a minimum price that they're looking at. You might do dash and then maximum price. Maximum price. So you might, instead of say minimum price, maximum price, just say price range. So you can do all kinds of stuff in there. Again, whatever fields are in there. If we don't have a built-in field for it, throw it into the notes. And it's good there. The rest of the fields are pretty basic. I do recommend, because of some things that are getting ready to happen within RealVolve, is that if it is a brand new lead, put it in there as aware. You've got aware, know, like, and trust for the stage. And suspect, prospect, lead, client, past client. Again, if it's coming from Zillow, it probably should be aware and suspect. Okay, and there's reasons for doing that. I'll do a whole nother video on why that is. If you have their birthday, their anniversaries, when they purchased their home, when they sold their home, you know, there's other date fields that are available that you can put in there. There's one here that says interested in property. If you wanted to, there's, you know, you could say interested in property, you could put that in there, or maybe just the address that they're looking for, you can put that in there. This is a merge field in an email as well. So you can say, hey, John, thanks for visiting Zillow. I see that you're interested in 123 Main Street. That's a merge field. You could then, you know, personalize your message so that they think that you're communicating with them more personally instead of, hey, I saw you visited the website. Let me know if there's anything I can do. So now I've assigned all my fields. I'm going to click on continue. It'll show you basically a summary of what you put in there. You can test it, create and continue. So what's going to happen now is it's going to test it and see if everything tests out good. If it does, you can look at the information that came back, just says it was successful, and then click on finish. It's going to ask you for a name of this zap, because you can have multiple zaps. I could say my leads from Zillow. I'm going to put it into this folder, which I'm in. Now, one thing I do recommend people do is whenever you type this in, hit tab on your keyboard. because I think there's a bug in Zapier where if you don't tab out of there and you just turn it on, the name doesn't stick. Yeah, so if you tab out, then it will. You can then make another zap or you can see it on your dashboard. So I'm going to click on see it on the dashboard. So here is my lead from Zillow and you can see that it's on. What will happen then if I come over here, we'll see here in our notifications, because I did the test, it went ahead and would have put Beth Homebuyer in there. Now, Beth Homebuyer technically was already in there, so you'll also see that it says was updated successfully. Okay. Most of these say, okay, like here, your contact blank was created successfully. If it says was updated successfully, it means we found that name either by phone number or by email address. I can then click on Beth Homebuyer. I can look at the information, and lo and behold, there it is. I am interested in, here's my list price, here's my price range. So it built that out. If I look at my tags, here's my new lead tag that I said that I wanted. And what was the other one? Buyer. That's pretty much it.